In a few minutes, I'm going to reveal to you the one and only thing you need to know to eat healthy. Yes, the one and only thing. I'm Dr. Nicholas Thackray, a family doctor in Port Elizabeth, South Africa, and welcome to Word Doctor, where we bring you wisdom in health and life. The word for the series is statin, and it's all about cholesterol, which is bad for you, right? Wrong. We plumbed the depths of Dr. Google's knowledge on episode one, and this is what she said about cholesterol.
Cholesterol is a waxy, fat-like substance that's found in your blood and every cell of your body.
Wait a minute. Rewind.
In every cell of your body.
All the cells in your body, like every cell, like there's no cell that does not have cholesterol in it. Well, Dr. Google is right. There is not one cell in your body that does not have cholesterol in it. Let me show you. Every cell in your body has a membrane. This membrane looks like this. The dots and zigzag lines are fat molecules called phospholipids. The hexagonal structures are cholesterol. This is the structure of every cell in your body, and in fact, every animal cell. It is a signature structure that is weaved into all of life. Did you know that your body can manufacture cholesterol from carbon, hydrogen, and water? Cholesterol is also the building block of some of the most vital organs in your body, including estrogen and progesterone. So, is cholesterol bad? No. You are made out of cholesterol. It's good. Even medical science is catching on and beginning to understand that cholesterol is not necessarily the enemy, and in the 2015 to 2020 dietary guidelines for Americans removed the recommendations of restricting dietary cholesterol. Do you remember the days when science told us that eggs were bad for you because they were high in cholesterol? Those were the days. Well, eggs are no longer bad for you. In fact, science now tells us that eggs are good for you. Will these people please make up their minds? The evidence of powerful scientific studies show us that people who get heart attacks and strokes have high levels of LDL cholesterol, so-called bad cholesterol, and low levels of HDL cholesterol, so-called good cholesterol. LDL and HDL are actually not technically cholesterol molecules, but a package of cholesterol surrounded by a specially designed membrane, which is water-soluble substance designed to deliver cholesterol through the body, through the water-based metabolic conveyor belt of the body called the bloodstream. If you just rearrange the letters of HDL cholesterol, you get DHL, cholesterol for delivery. Now, I'm going to confuse you totally. The stuff that is inside of so-called good cholesterol and bad cholesterol is exactly the same. It's just packaged differently. Hashtag say what? Okay, if you're still watching, then big up to you. Let's lay it down in simple terms. What you need to know to eat healthy. As promised, here is the one and only thing you need to know to eat healthy. It's not complicated at all. It's just not easy in the modern world. Ladies and gentlemen, the one thing is to know the difference between processed and unprocessed foods. Whole foods versus refined foods. Let's give you an example. Man, that was a process. And there you have it, processed food. But nowadays, we have machinery to do all the dirty work for us, and processed food is just food in the shop. So an orange is an example of whole food, but it comes with other good nutrients and also an essential ingredient for healthy eating, fiber, which you may lose in processed orange juice. So if you were to choose to eat an orange or drink a glass of orange juice, which would it be? I'll leave the choice to you, but as you can see, healthy eating can take some effort, like peeling the orange, but in the end, it's worth your health. In summary, whole foods are better than processed foods. In our final episode, we will look at cholesterol-lowering medication, commonly called statins, and where it comes in handy. Also, in this episode, we looked at good and bad cholesterol. Ever wondered what the difference between good and bad fats? Turn on notifications if you don't want to miss it. Stay safe and see you soon.